Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on signs and symptoms of a failing head gasket. The head gasket on an internal combustion engine is responsible for sealing the engine block and cylinder head and ultimately preventing any combustion gases, oil, or coolant from losing pressure or leaking. A failing head gasket or a leaking head gasket is commonly referred to or known as a blown head gasket. Head gasket failure and a blown head gasket can be a very serious failure. It could be expensive to fix, and on top of that, if it's not caught and fixed in time, it can cause significant damage to the engine depending on exactly how the head gasket fails and what the severity of it is, but it is an urgent repair. As a final note before diving into the symptoms here, I do want to point out there are a couple different ways in which a head gasket can fail. So it is possible for the head gasket to essentially fail externally, which would be the gasket generally failing on the outer edges, which could then just lead to coolant leaking out of the side of the head gasket and the side of the cylinder head, and ultimately forming a puddle or dripping below the vehicle. However, it's much more common for head gaskets to fail internally, where further inside the gasket, something cracks, and that ultimately leads to coolant and combustion gases being lost inside of the engine rather than it escaping outside of the engine. And ultimately, the internal head gasket failures are going to be a lot more significant and severe because that is what results in engine coolant entering the combustion chambers, as well as coolant mixing with oil, among some of the other issues that pop up with head gasket failure. With that said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common signs and symptoms of a blown head gasket. One of the most common symptoms of head gasket failure is coolant loss. So tying this into with what I discussed about internal or external head gasket leaks, it's possible that it's just leaking externally. You have a crack or an issue on the very edge of the gasket, and it's just allowing some coolant to escape and leak out of the side of the head gasket, but not internally to the engine. In this case, you'll likely notice a visible puddle underneath the vehicle or visible drips of coolant once you park the vehicle for an extended period of time. However, again, more likely it is going to be coolant loss due to internal issues with the head gasket. And so at that point, you won't notice any visible leaks or symptoms apart from the check engine light or the low coolant light being triggered. And if you manually check the coolant expansion tank, noticing that the coolant is low, and ultimately that coolant is entering the combustion chambers and burning off in the cylinders, or it may also be mixing with the engine oil. And so ultimately, if you have unexplained coolant loss, you're consistently losing coolant, but you don't see any visible leaks, you don't know where it is going, then a blown head gasket is a very likely cause of that issue. Moving on to symptom number two of a failing head gasket, we have milky oil. When engine oil and coolant mix together, that will often make the oil look very milky, kind of a brownish, almost like a chocolate milkshake. So if you are noticing that milky oil, then it's very likely that coolant or some other foreign substance or fluid is entering the engine oil. And so ultimately, if you are noticing milky oil, especially during an oil change, that could be a very dead giveaway that your head gasket is beginning to fail and allowing oil and coolant to mix together. Now, one thing to mention here with milky oil, this is a very serious symptom of a head gasket failure. And the reason for that is when coolant mixes with the engine oil, it affects the oil's ability to properly lubricate the engine. And so that can lead to accelerated wear and tear on the engine. And if it's allowed to happen for long enough, potentially even lead to complete engine failure or costly internal engine damage and repairs. Moving on to the next symptom of a blown head gasket at number three here, we have white smoke from the exhaust. So in this case, when coolant is allowed to enter one of the cylinders of the engine, the coolant will burn off and show in the form of white smoke coming from your exhaust. It's important to note, most vehicles do produce some light smoke on a cold start, especially on a cold day. It's not actually smoke. You can just kind of see some of the steam coming out. So if you're noticing that, don't panic right away. Oftentimes, if you have head gasket failure, the white smoke coming from your exhaust can be pretty severe and very noticeable, especially as the head gasket failure progresses and becomes worse and worse. You'll likely start noticing more more and more white smoke coming from the exhaust as more coolant is allowed to enter the combustion chambers. White smoke from the exhaust is going to be one of the main symptoms and really one of the most visible symptoms without even having to pop the hood or really look in the engine. If you are seeing that white smoke, a lot of the times that can be a dead giveaway that you are having issues with your head gasket. Symptom number four of a failing head gasket or blown head gasket, we have the engine overheating. There are multiple ways in which the engine can overheat when your head gasket actually fails. One of the main reasons for that is going to be when you have the combustion gases that are allowed to mix into the engine coolant. That's naturally going to reduce the cooling system's ability to keep the engine cool. And on top of that, that can be further exacerbated by the fact that when those combustion gases mix with the coolant, that can form pockets and air bubbles within the cooling system, which can then get trapped and cause further overheating of the engine. Another way that the engine may overheat with head gasket failure is, again, coolant loss is one of the main symptoms behind head gasket failure. And so if your coolant levels are getting too low because you haven't topped it up and you've been losing coolant into the cylinders or mixing with oil wherever it is going, you may be low enough on coolant that you don't have enough coolant in the vehicle to actually keep the engine cool. So really a couple different ways there in which a blown head gasket can lead to the engine overheating. Last but not least, symptom number five, a couple things combined here, and that is low compression, power loss, and poor performance. Ultimately, this ties into the combustion gases escaping through a blown head gasket. When those combustion gases are allowed to escape, you no longer have an airtight cylinder, which means as the piston is trying to compress the air within the cylinder, it's just simply escaping out of the head gasket. That is going to lead to lower compression in that cylinder around the area where your head gasket has failed or cracked. If you do run into low compression with head gasket failure, low compression is going to directly affect performance and can result in power loss, just poor performance in general, as well as rough engine operation. One of the easiest ways to double check is to actually compression test all of your engine cylinders. By compression testing them, you can figure out roughly where in the head gasket the failure is occurring, assuming it is the head gasket that is responsible for the low compression. So ultimately, when it comes to a blown head gasket, it is a very expensive job. Unfortunately, the parts can generally be pretty cheap. If you look at just the head gasket or head gaskets, depending on whether you have a V engine or an inline engine, just the parts for replacing the head gaskets are generally about $50 to $150 or so. However, it is a very, very labor intensive job. And often you will be looking at labor in excess of $1,000 to $1,500 is pretty standard labor to pay if you end up at a repair shop with a blown head gasket. One other thing to consider there is if you are moving forward with the head gasket replacement, there are a number of other cheaper, simple, and expensive components along the way, like other gasket seals. That's often worthwhile replacing just since those are inexpensive parts. And while you're already in there doing the labor or paying for the labor, might as well go ahead and replace a couple things if you're making that investment in fixing the head gasket and planning on keeping the vehicle for a while. So ultimately, if you do run into head gasket failure, unfortunately, if you end up at a repair shop, if you're not doing the job on your own, it can be very costly and ultimately end up somewhere in that $1,250 to $2,000 ballpark to replace a blown head gasket. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more. Thanks, everyone.